at one stage in the deciding game before winning it in three. Fabio Beto of Italy, our umpire for this women's doubles final. So, Zhang Yawen and Pan Pan, far side of the court with the black shirts, up against the Danes, the current European champions, Camilla Rutajul, the left-hander, and Lea Freya Christiansen. It's a good opening rally. But that defensive shot has gone long of the back line. A big smile from Camilla Rutajul, who is the current world mixed doubles champion with Thomas Laybourne. Well, if we ever rallies like that all the way through, it's quite understandable how the Danes took an hour and 16 minutes for their semi-final yesterday. First ever time that this Danish pair have been in a Super Series tournament final. Of course, the Super Series, 12 tournaments a year. And this Danish Open is event 9 on the 12 tournament tour. Tour, of course, moves on to Paris next week. And then the remaining two Super Series events in November, Hong Kong Open and China Open. Oh, that's a very good return of serve from Lea Freya.
Service over. 2-0.
Now, obviously, as this is the first ever tournament that the Chinese players have played together, it means that these two pairs have not played each other previously.
Service over. 3-2.
Just snatched at that a little, and I can't help but wonder whether the physical demands of their quarter and semi-finals, the Danish combination going the full distance in both of those, an hour and 2 hours 26 minutes for those two matches, whether that's going to take its physical toll today and going to be an influence in this final. Pushed it wide. Chinese pair have opened up a 3-point cushion. Zhang Yawen, 6 world championship medals to her name. 1 gold, 2 silver and 3 bronze. There she is. So experienced. Add to that an Olympic bronze medal. Realise the class of her as a women's doubles player. Well, you wouldn't have thought from that rally that this was the first time they've ever played an international competition together. Good understanding. One setting it up for the other.
Service over. 3-6.
Now just wide of the mark again.
Service over. 7-3.
One of the Danes, as we look at the Chinese coach, Zhang Jun, former Olympic champion, twice Olympic champion in the mixed doubles with Gao Ling, 2000 and 2004. Good placement of the smash. That's what the Danes have got to do. When you've got a new pairing who don't have that understanding yet of who goes to full, which shot down the center, play as many down the center as possible, confuse them as much as possible. Luck of the net cord for Pan Pan. 8-5. The Danes have improved so much in recent months. So much more patient in their style of play.
8.
Getting a lot more thought to where to place the shot. Well, it's called good. I have to say, my instinctive reaction was
7-8.
That the shuttle was long. Yeah. Well, it's no wonder that the Chinese players feel a little aggrieved by that. Of course, we're treated to the replay and can make a perhaps more informed judgment. Line judge has to make a split second decision. Yeah, sound judgment.
Service over. 9-7.
Altercation as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not. Oof, goodness me, that was close. Crowd here very much trying to encourage their players. Oh, it's a very good low serve from Pan Pan.
Seven,
it means that the Chinese combination, the number six seeds, go to the mid-game interval with a 4-point advantage. So 11-7 in this opening game, women's doubles final here at the Denmark Open. Good placement of the smash.
12-7.
A little bit flatter that time. Four straight points to the Chinese pair from 8-7. Five straight points.
13-7.
Service fault call struck above the waist, says the service judge, Cornelia Schroeder of Germany. Yeah, a little shake of the head from Pam Pan, doesn't agree. Oh, goodness me. Well, it's all dependent on the definition of the waist, isn't it? Tapping the shuttle down into the mid-court area, past the net player. Oh, yes, that's landed in. A smile from Pan Pan. She knows that was a bad misjudgment. Seemed to be in control of the rally. A rally. Defense by the Danes, absolutely desperation at stages, but it was worth the effort. And I think that's another area of the game that the Danes have improved so much, their defensive play. Just long.
Service over, 15-10.
Yeah, good call. Very impressed with the improvement on the defensive play of the Danish players. Initially, when the flat fast exchanges were happening, I thought that's not the right tactics for the Danes. They have to slow it up. They'll not win at the fast exchanges against the Chinese players, who are absolutely superb at that. But I think, to prove me wrong, they're just showing how much they have improved that area of their game. Lars Uarp, the head coach of the Danish team, nods his approval.
12-15.
Yeah, good call too. Was just long. A brilliant third shot from Lena Freer. serves out wide, looks for the little push down her backhand side. Full stretch, but she manages to reach it and control it in a downward direction. Very, very good play. Really good passage of play here from the Danes. Four straight points, and they've narrowed the margin to just one solitary point. Oh, unbelievable. Took the defensive shot so early. This is the one, whips it down the line, and it's all level, having been 5 points adrift. And now into the lead, six straight points. Well, my goodness, I said this was a good passage of play for the European champions. Didn't really gain any advantage from the flick serve.
16-0.
Zhang Yao Wen able to read that and deal with it well. Level once more. Having fought so hard to get back into this opening game. Danes mustn't relax, they mustn't think the hard work is done. And in the end, the error from Pan Pan. Perhaps Chinese player getting a little bit frustrated that so many of their shots just kept coming back by the Danes, that she was trying to make it an even more acute angle. Have to remember that they've been on court almost an hour longer in than their opponents in reaching this final. Chinese just an hour and 56 minutes for their three matches. The Danes 2 hours 51 minutes for their three matches. The line. Well, once again, Chinese players think they've been hard done by. In fact, Pan Pan is pointing to the giant screen to see the replay. She thinks that's going to argue her case. There she is. Now, let's have a closer look at this. No, that found the line. Time. Yeah, well, the umpire is only allowed to overrule a line judge if he sees that a clear error has been made. Well, I think the replays showed that and learned it in. No question of that one, so well on with the back line. 18-all.
18-all.
Pushed it wide. The most experienced player on court making the error.
Seve Silva, 19-18.
2 points away from this opening game. The number two seeds from Denmark. Oh, that was a dreadful serve. Got away with it, though. Oh, my goodness, Mitt hit. They got away with a dreadful serve and a complete miss hit in the middle of that rally. No wonder they smile. That was a total... It came off the frame of the racket. Two game points for the Danes. She started the rally with a very nervous-looking flick serve. Lena Freer, and then makes the error in the end. It was a golden opportunity. But one game point well saved by the Chinese pair. Would you believe it? What a time to get a lucky net cord. And the Chinese pair are back level. We'll need extra points until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. Another error from Lena Freer.
21-20.
So having saved two game points now, the Chinese pair have a game point of their own. Take it, four straight points from two game points down to take the opening game. 22-20, Pan Pan and Zhang Yawen. Well, they've weathered the storm. And I have to say, I thought the Danes looked a little bit nervous when they had their opportunities and therefore went a little bit defensive. So all credit to the Chinese pair who take the opening game 22-20 in 23 minutes. Thank you. Well, they certainly had their opportunities, two of them to be precise, two game points for the Danes in that opening game at 2018. But they couldn't convert, and therefore the number six seeds, Pan Pan and Zhang Yao Wen, taking the opening game 22-20. But for the Danish fans, they shouldn't be too alarmed about that. Their last two matches, the quarterfinal and the semi-final yesterday, both against Japanese opponents, they lost the opening game in both of those matches before coming back to win them in three very tough games. Great understanding between the two Danes in that rally. One covering, one pulled out of position, the other one moves round to cover. Pair reached the semi-final earlier this year of the Singapore Open. In the quarterfinal, they beat Pan Pan playing with Tian Qing. So they certainly know how to beat Pan Pan. But of course, Pan Pan now playing with the current world champion. I believe they are a stronger combination, there's no question of that. Yeah, good aggressive play. Turn their defense into attack.
4-2.
Yeah, really got to nowadays in women's doubles work until you can intercept at the net and finish it off from the front of the court, because very, very rarely can you hit winners from the back. It's a good defensive shot from Ruta Yule. Played on the backhand, drives it up the line.
Thank you.
Just three career titles for the Danish pair. Twice won the Dutch Open in 2004, 2008, and of course when they won the European Championships last year as well. But this is a great start by the Danes to this second game. Well, it was a good low serve, and I think Lina Fria was right to try and intercept the shot, because of course the little push was going towards her partner's backhand side. Good rally. Well, there's a couple of errors at the net from Lina Fria. But I'm encouraged to see her keeping going for those, looking to intercept. It's no good standing back and just waiting for things to happen. You've got to make it happen. And she's far more adventurous nowadays than she was a couple of years ago. And that's great to see.
Over 7-4.
Yes, I think as far as this Chinese pair is concerned, she is the weakness. Pan Pan. Just by virtue of the fact you only have to look at the record of Zhang Yawen. Current All England champion, current world champion, Olympic bronze medalist. She didn't look weak in that rally, did she? And that's the problem, because even the weaker of the two players, two Chinese players, is so good. Pushed it long.
6-7.
Now just 1 point the deficit. Had been 4 points adrift at 2-6. To get themselves out of trouble. A real clash of the rackets earlier on, and that was the situation. They both went for the same shot down the middle, but they managed to keep the rally going and then turned it into a very positive rally indeed. Well, that's clever. Yeah, well worked rally by the Chinese combination.
8-0.
And they've worked their way back level in this second game. My word, that's sensational. Well, I said just a few rallies ago, she was right to keep trying to intercept, and that's why. Smash finds the top of the net.
9-0.
They remain positive. Something that a couple of years ago, against the top Chinese players or Korean players, sometimes their patience deserted them. Different pair now. Different players now. Improved technically in so many departments. Not only the mental toughness and the patience.
Service over. 10-9.
Just too much pace on the return of serve. Well, that's the shot she was playing for. That's the one she wanted. Just too good at the return.
Service over.
goodness me. Well, we see that shot quite often in men's doubles, but very rarely in women's doubles. That angled cross-court smash winner. But it was played to perfection. She'd set herself up by having played the drop shot on the previous shot. And they have a one-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Good interception again. Clever, very, very clever shot from Lena Freer. Courageous shot to attempt as well, a cross-court net shot. Running repairs to the chute. So much more positive on her defensive play, Lena Freer.
13,
she's
11.
In the last year really has become a world-class player, stepped up a level. We've known from mixed doubles results that Camilla Ruta-Yule has been a world-class player for a couple of years now, but her partner has stepped up to the mark. Look at that. Yell from Lena Freer
14,
to her partner
11.
To leave it well wide.
Thank you.
And the Chinese players just asking for the court to be mopped. Perhaps need to recompose the thoughts, refocus. Scrambling the shuttle back just one more time. Something the Chinese are masters at themselves, but now the Danes doing it to the Chinese players. And it's the Chinese players who are running out of patience and making the errors. Four-point cushion now for the Danes. Good flick serve.
Correction, ouch.
Oof. Well, correction from the umpire. Umpire just saying that he saw clearly that that was out. Well, not convinced by that. Oof. Well. Yeah, maybe the umpire was right. Danes mustn't allow that overruled call to disturb their focus and their concentration, their determination to keep playing a positive game. Easier said than done, though. So. That's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
14-15.
Well, I think too spectacular, just calmly playing the shuttle, placing it into the open space. And they've narrowed the gap to, once again, just 1 point. It's a good return of serve. Players allowed to go off and have a towel down. No argument this time from Pan Pan. Previous best here at the Danish Open for this Danish pair was a semi-final back in 2006, 3 years ago, when they lost out to Gail Emms and Donna Kellogg from England. Quarter-finalists last year.
16-14.
Oh, yeah. There's the confusion I said in the opening game, because this Chinese combination, a new pairing, don't have the understanding yet of who takes which shot down the centre of the court. And that was absolutely perfect placement. Unbelievable. This is great rally. It's a big point as well. Very, very important. Both pairs know it. Oh, the attempted drop shot from the world mixed doubles champion finds the net.
Service over, 15-17.
So difficult to actually put the shuttle on the floor nowadays. The women's doubles players have such solid defences. Where are the weaknesses? So difficult to find.
Thank you.
Going to go wide. Yeah.
Service over, 18-15.
Next serve is long. Of that double service line, and every time it gets a little bit close, I remember on the Dane's first game point in that opening game, she used the flick serve, and I think part of that is nerves. Good play by the Chinese pair.
18.
stepping into the defensive shots, driving the shuttle back, putting pace on it.
Service over. 19-17. Out. 20-17.
Well, the line judge initially calling it in. Difficult to tell from that. But the umpire overrules the line judge, and it means that the Danes now have 3 game points. Remember, they had 2 in the opening game but couldn't convert. Chinese players incensed by that overrule. Well, one game point has come and gone. They went a little bit too passive on their game points in the opening game, did the Danes. There they are, they're passive again. Drive from Lena Freer, and the Danes convert on their second opportunity. We're going to be treated to a third and deciding game in this women's doubles
second
final.
Game won by Camilla Ruteyu, Lena Freer Christiansen, 21-18.
21-18 calls the umpire. 48 minutes now, this match in progress. And nothing as yet between these two pairs.
Final game, level flag.
So the European champions from Denmark, Lena Freer Christiansen and Camilla Ruteyul, getting this third and deciding game underway against this new Chinese pairing of Pan Pan and Zhang Yawen.
Service over. One lock.
Pushed it wide.
Lock.
Yeah, well, of course, we know that the left-hander, Camilla Ruti-Yule, is an excellent player from the front of the court. She wouldn't be world mixed doubles champion if she wasn't, but what has been a real revelation in this tournament is the quality of Lina Freya Kristiansen. When she's going forward, she's so much more adventurous. She's really looking to try and intercept much more, get involved more. Well, confusion. Been playing together since they were juniors. To be careful with their clears from this near side of the court, because we've noticed all week there's a bit of a drift here in this lovely arena, and the shuttle is flying a little bit faster going towards that far side of the court where the Chinese are at the moment. Combination play. Happy with herself. Important as far as the home fans are concerned to see their players stick with the Chinese, don't let them get too much of a lead in this deciding game. Oh, they've drawn level. As the fans yesterday, when this Danish women's doubles pair were playing, well, they were 9-13 down in the deciding game, 17-19 down in the deciding game before coming through to beat Shizuka Masuko and Nami Naito. 21-19 in the deciding game.
Service over. 6-5.
It was a real opportunity. The lift was not particularly deep.
Seven, five.
And the tall left-hander, And she is tall, 1 metre 83. It's just over 6 foot. She should have perhaps made more of that. Well, makes amends. Good return of serve.
Service over. 6-7.
Well, whilst they have improved those flat fast rallies and much, much better at that nowadays, the Danes, I'm still not convinced they want to get embroiled too often in those exchanges. Like to see them trying to mix up the pace. Oh, that is brilliant. Well, Pan Pan in that rally was sensational. Not only the final winning shot, but she had retrieved a neck cord in the middle of the rally, managed to react to it, and then comes up with a stunning winner like that. Well, I was saying just a moment ago, important for the Danes to stay in touch before they change ends. Chinese pair now with a 3-point advantage. Yeah, it's the shuttle getting caught with the drift in this arena. Just taken a fraction long of that line. Pushed it way long.
11-6.
And the Chinese pair with a 5-point advantage as the players change ends in this deciding game. So the players return to court and the match time ticks over to exactly an hour. It's 5 straight points for the Chinese pair. Good passage of play from them. The Danish fans quite vocal in their hope that the Danes will bring this to an end. It's a run of points for China. Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, how did she get it back? That's absolutely extraordinary. It's about to say that's a brilliant winner. Somehow she got it back, and then the error from Pan Pan. What a return. Oh, goodness me. She does have a large repertoire of shots. Left Pan Pan stranded. That's a terrific smash from Pan Pan. Just slightly across the body of Lina Freya. Aiming towards that right shoulder. Getting a little tangled up in her defensive stance there. The same smash again, once again across the body, aiming towards the right shoulder of Lina Freya Christiansen. Here it comes, she lifts cross court, hoping that the smash is going to come down at her partner. We've increased the cushion to 7 points now. Awfully difficult for the Danes to come back from this sort of deficit. And a little bit of desperation showing in their play. Yeah. Camilla Orutiul knew that she'd broken the strings of her racket. That's why she just stood at the front of the court. Knew she couldn't really do much to help out her partner. That's great judgment from Pan Pan, letting the shuttle drop long of that back line. And I think the Danes now are staring over the edge of the precipice. That's a well-worked rally. And their determination and resolve is unwavering. Just wide, difficult to control. I think the shuttle bounced off the top of the table, was certainly deflected by the net cord. 3 points away from the title. Well, so many players at an 8 point deficit would virtually give up the fight, but not this Danish pair. But surely they've left it a little too late. Well, you have to believe. But the opportunities for the home players are running out fast. And now, this new Chinese pairing on the verge of victory. Twice previously, Zhang Yawen has been defeated finalist here. And it looks as if it's going to be third time lucky. Well, may have a very substantial lead, but still getting nervous. Pan Pan. Missed it. It's gone wide. And this new combination of Pan Pan and Zhang Yawen have defeated the European champions in a spectacular final. Wonderful encounter. 1 hour and 9 minutes.
Match won by Pan Pan, Zhang Yawen, 22-20, 18-21, 21-12.
The umpire confirming the score. This final rally, well, the defence from Pan Pan was incredible. Desperation. Her first Super Series title. And she's achieved it with Zhang Yawen. 22-20, 18-21, 21-12 in the deciding game in 1 hour and 9 minutes.